creating professional invoices. Frustrating, right? It's time-consuming, repetitive, and not to mention boring. But there is a way to simplify that entire process using one powerful tool. By the end of this video, you will know how to create your custom invoice generator using CKEditor and make your invoicing process efficient, customizable, and totally stress-free. So let's dive in. First, let's talk about CKEditor itself. It's a fantastic rich text editor that integrates seamlessly with frameworks like Angular, React, or Vue. For this tutorial, we're using React to build our invoice generator. But here's the best part. We at CKEditor recently introduced Builder, the one you're seeing on the screen, that makes the setup process incredibly easy. With Builder, you can customize your editor, select your preferred framework, and get a visual preview of your starter project, all with just a few clicks. Let me show you how. Let's walk through the four quick steps to get your starter project up and running. First, select your preset. For this video, we're going with the classic editor. It's the perfect option for a clean and simple starting point. Once you've made your selection, hit next to proceed. Now, this is where the CKEditor's builder really shines. We can enable key features that will tailor our editor to creating invoices. We'll start by enabling tables to organize invoice items, lists to break down services or information, and headings for things like billed to and performed work. These are essential for structuring our invoice. Here's a pro tip: if you want to take your invoice generator to the next level, enable premium features like templates and merge fields. Templates will allow you to save reusable invoice formats, and merge fields are great for inserting repetitive data, like customer names or dates. And of course, don't forget export to PDF, so you can easily download your invoice when you're done. With that set of features, we will be able to produce invoices that look like that one, with a good structure, a professional look and feel, and the ability to customize it to your needs. It's important to mention that you need a license key to use premium features. You can find a link in the description how to get one. At this next step, you can customize how your toolbar behaves. You can choose to collapse buttons that don't fit in a single line, or add a balloon toolbar that appears for a highlighted text. But for now, we will keep it simple and stick with the default configuration. And finally, step 4, downloading the project itself. You can pick one of many options, but for this video, we will select React as our technology, choose the self-hosted option for the integration method, and finally, we will select the download project option. And now you have your very own CKEditor instance ready to go. With our project downloaded, it's time to tweak the default configuration. As you can see, Builder generated a really standard React application with Vite and CKEditor as dependencies. Now find the app.jsx file. This is where the CKEditor component lives. If you have never tried CKEditor before, this code might look confusing, but worry not, I will break it down for you. As you can see, we have an editor config object, which is the editor's heart. We have the following properties there: a toolbar that contains an array of items. Here we define which functional elements are visible in the toolbar, in which order they are displayed, and logically group these elements using the straight line separator. Next, we have plugins. Here we list the plugins needed for the toolbar buttons to function. Plugins are exported from two packages, CKEditor 5 and CKEditor 5 premium features. We also have some default configurations that are predefined by the builder. We will talk about that in a minute. And finally, we have a license key property, and you need it if you plan to use premium features. In our case, we will use premium features. That's why I stored my license key in a variable and passed it to this property. We'll be configuring editor to handle invoices specifically. Let's start by tweaking the tables plugin configuration. For example, we will use multiple tables for our invoices. And we want all of these tables to follow the similar rule. The first row is a heading row by default. You can easily configure that by adding some code to your configuration. Now, let's make our invoice generator even more powerful with templates. CKEditor's templating feature allows you to predefine reusable document structures. In our case, we'll be setting a custom invoice template. In the CKEditor config, locate the template definitions and add a new entry for our invoice template. Here is an example of a minimal, clean invoice template. If you want to use my exact template, you can find a link in the description to the GitHub repo. And now, every time you need to create a new invoice, simply select your template and fill in the details. Simple as that. Let's say you missed a feature when creating a starter project using Builder, like slash commands. Slash commands can allow you to insert templates by pressing slash. Let's fix that. We need to import the slash commands plugin and include it in the editor's config. By default, slash command shows all of the available options, which might not be something you're looking for. Let's modify the list of items that show up when you press the slash. Now, when you press slash in your editor, you can see that only invoice is available in the list. And this is a good example how you can modify the default behavior of plugins. Now let's talk about merge fields. These are awesome for automating repetitive parts of your invoice, things like client names, invoice dates, or even total amounts. To set this up, you only need to define merge fields in your editor's config. Each definition consists of three properties: ID, label, and default value. Here are the definitions you can use to understand the concept a little better: my name and the invoice date. Now let's replace the hard-coded parts of our invoice to actually use merge fields. Once that's done, you can use those fields when creating new invoices. And they'll automatically populate with the correct data when you generate a new invoice template. It's a huge time saver and helps ensure consistency across all of your invoices. Now that our setup looks good, it's time to export our invoice to a PDF file. This is where the PDF export plugin comes in handy. We don't need to add any code manually because we actually added this plugin when we used Builder. With just a click, CKEditor converts your styled invoice into a downloadable PDF file. No need for additional tools or software. You can even customize the layout and appearance of your PDF with options like custom margins, page orientation, and format. Once everything configured, click the PDF icon in the toolbar and voila, you have a professional invoice ready to go. And there we have it. We've built a fully customizable invoice generator using CKEditor in just a few simple steps. With powerful features like templates, slash commands, merge fields, and exported PDF, we improved the entire invoicing process and saved tons of time. If you want to try this particular setup, check the description of this video. You can find a link to the GitHub repo there. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this one. But for now, thank you so much for watching. Until next time.